Alright, hey guys! So I feel inspired to make this really quick video. I'm hoping that it would be quick, but this is something that I've been meaning to say for the past few days, and I just feel like all of these ideas and words, they're sort of just burning and they're boiling. They're coming to a boil in my creative cauldron, as I like to say, and I just gotta let it out somewhere. I was writing a blog post, but I just didn't feel like that was direct enough, so I feel compelled to make a video. So here's what I want to say. Recently, I've discovered that talking about productivity, talking about creativity, those things are really things that I enjoy talking about. And I think being productive means being a better you, getting better at being yourself, being the best of yourself. So that translates into being the best of yourself at work, creating the best work, manage time management, paper planning, digital planning, ways that you utilize, ways that discover that you discover to help yourself become better at adapting a healthier lifestyle, a more productive lifestyle. So I feel like the word productivity really ties into self-expression, creative living, and just living a good life, living a good life in which you're at your best, living a good life in which you create the conditions in order for you to be at your best. So I feel like that's what productivity means to me. And having that said, I kind of want to address this one super important thing when it comes to productivity. Basically, if you're wondering about how I can be more productive, how do I accomplish more things in a span of a day? So the answer I would give you, like the first thing I would say, is productivity is very individual. It's a very personal thing because everybody has a different personality, a unique working style. Everybody has a different pace. So there's really no one size fits all productivity system that's going to just click with you. And it takes exploring, discovering, it takes some work for you to find that groove, for you to find the best conditions for yourself, for you to find what makes you tick. So it takes a lot of reflection, it takes a lot of self-understanding and experimenting and putting the things that you've discovered into practice for you to discover what's the best productive mode for you. So that's the first thing I would say. If you want to be productive, just know that it's your own process. It's something that you have to discover and create for yourself. But on top of that, I feel like the most important thing when it comes to being productive, it doesn't matter who you are. You could be a creative worker, you could be a salary person, you could have a blue collar job, you could be a teacher, you could be, whatever it is that you're pursuing, whatever it is your career, even if you're just a mom, even if you're just whatever it is that comprises your life, that makes up your life, The one thing that you cannot get away with, and the one thing that you have to prioritize, the one thing that you have to do in order to become more productive is you gotta take care of yourself. And by that, I means taking care of yourself in all kinds of ways, in all areas of your life. So physically, emotionally, mentally, and spiritually. And out of those four things, the most important thing is your physical health. And of course, I'm not saying like the other three things aren't as important enough, but I just feel like I think I put it on the top of the list is because not enough of us prioritize physical health as I guess a criteria or a prerequisite to becoming more productive. Because without your physical health, you can't feel happy. You won't have the energy to do any of the work that you have to do for your emotional and mental health. And if you don't take care of your body, which is part of your spirit, which is the vessel that your spirit carries, you cannot participate in this physical world. You can't participate in this physical plane in the best way that you can. You can't be the best version of yourself. And if you don't, that's why I feel like that's the most important thing. Because if you don't take care of this physical vessel, whatever your beliefs are about spirit or mind, body, spirit, whatever, however you believe our existences work, if you don't take care of this vessel, this body that participates in this physical plane that does work for you, like that it's the thing that you had to embody to do stuff, to accomplish things. If you don't make it into the best If you don't give it your all, if you don't make it, give it the best that you've got. You don't take care of it, you don't fuel it with enough energy or new nutrients or sleep, then you can't accomplish anything. And I know that a lot of people are resistant to this idea of, you have to exercise more, you have to eat more, you have to sleep more and sleep regularly. I feel like we all know these things, and we all know what's healthy for us. We all know what are the things that are not healthy for us. But there's such a resistance to the idea of being healthy or cultivating healthy habits, and this is coming from my personal experiences. And if you know me, if you're within my social circle and you're hearing this, I'm sorry that, I kind of made a video out of this, and but this is just how I feel. Like, sometimes it's very concerning when you see the people that you love or care about, and then they don't seem to care about themselves as much as you care about them, and it's a weird feeling. And this is something that I care deeply about. It's something that this is something that if I were to teach something, if I could teach one person something about themselves, or if I only get one chance or one thing that I get to impart to the other person, to a random person, then I would choose health over anything else. Because without health, you're absolutely nothing. Without health, you can't do anything. Because I feel like as a society, we are so disconnected from our own mortality. We are so disconnected from our own body to the point where we willingly, or we sort of have sort of consciously ingest these things that are toxic for our bodies. We choose to sleep late, or we choose to not exercise, or we choose to sort of, even if we don't have any sort of overly unhealthy habits, such as smoking or drinking, we still sort of keep up with the habits that we know are bad for our bodies. And I think part of that is because, everybody has their reasons, but I think part of that is because we are so disconnected from our body and from the fact that we are mortal. So there's this profound disconnection between us as a living being and also with our sense of mortality. And I feel like that's so important to know that we are mortal and that eventually we're all going to die. Our body is mortal. Our body is going to die at some point, and it's not forever. And our health is exactly what we put in, what you eat, how much you sleep, how much you exercise or not exercise, the choices that we make for our health, the choices that we make in regards to our body. It's a finite currency. Our health is a finite currency, because unlike the mistakes in life that we make, we could be fired from a job, or we could lose a job, we could lose somebody in a relationship, we could really fuck up and really just fall off our chair and just hit our head against a wall and just start bleeding for no reason, or because we hit our head against a wall. But you know what I mean? Mistakes do happen in life, and unfortunate things do happen in life. But as long as we have ourselves, as long as we have that inner self that could always pick ourselves back up again, as long as we have that kind of support, or even without a support system, we're able to get back up again. We're able to get back up because we know that sense of self, our ability to choose, is never taken away from us, never ever truly taken away from us. But health is the mistakes that you make with health. Sometimes, and more often than not, it's a permanent thing. Those mistakes, and accumulative, or suddenly, or and the mistakes that happen in any shape or form or way, the mistakes that happened when it comes to your health, the damage is irreversible. Sometimes you come down with a serious illness, and then your organs become destroyed or worn down, and sometimes it's irreversible. Sometimes you may never get another liver or another pancreas or another pair of lungs. Like, you will never get those things back. And sometimes those mistakes, or the little mistakes or choices that we sort of allow ourselves to make, might eventually kill you, and you die. You literally just die from your mistakes. And And that's just the nature of being mortal, you know? The nature of being mortal is that we are, our bodies don't live forever. Our spirits do. I believe that. I believe our spirits are simply transformed when we pass on, when we go to the other side. But our bodies, it's exactly what we put in. It's like a bank, and every day you have to put good investment in it, or else you end up with a debt. And this debt, if you get to a point where this debt is too big, you don't get to do over again in this lifetime. You don't get to do that. And I feel like part of the reason why we don't really think about this is we don't think about the fact that we're immortal. We sort of shun the idea of death or suffering. We sort of just shove it underneath our carpet and we don't think about it. But I think we should think about it. And the reason why I care about this so much is it's actually a story that I'm not ready to tell yet, you know. So, but in the future, I would definitely share this with you. But it's just know that for now, it's definitely something that's very close to my heart is the importance of health, the importance of connecting with our mortality, the importance of taking care of ourselves. And that's just, you know, that's even beyond productivity. You know, if you want to live a good life, if you want to live a, if you want to be in a good relationship, if you want to be happy, if you want to do anything in life, you need to have your health. And there is absolutely no way around that. But yeah, I guess going back to the topic of being productive, how does this connect to being productive? So I think the connection is very obvious, but I just want to break it down for you anyway, because I think it's so important, right? So if you want to be productive, you gotta be healthy. And I understand there could be a lot of reluctance or resistance. You could, you know, you could feel like I don't have time to exercise. I don't have time to actually sit, you know, spend time to cook a healthy meal, or I don't have the energy to exercise after a really long work day. And I understand, and I think it feels really difficult and it feels really challenging when you want to make healthy decisions, but it seems like your lifestyle doesn't support those decisions, or the demands in your current life don't support those decisions, and maybe even some people in your life don't support those kind of decisions. But I know it seems like you're giving up a lot, that you're going to give up a lot if you make these healthy decisions, but it's the exact opposite. You're actually giving up more if you choose to sort of just kind of live like a zombie and not take care of your body, not eat right, and not sleep enough. It's actually worse because you're cashing out your health, you're cashing out day after day after day, and then one day that debt is gonna catch up to you. Like, without a doubt, that debt will catch up to you. Just think about it for a second. Would you rather spend even just a good half an hour doing some kind of exercise? Would you rather just spend a good half an hour doing that and feel good for the rest of your day, or not spend that half an hour sometime during your day and feel like shit for the entire day? Because I'm telling you, it makes a difference. When you train your body to be stronger, you feel better. I don't even need to be a scientist or a physician or some kind of nutritionist to tell you this. You know, this is coming from personal experience. Ever since I started working out regularly and sticking with it, I felt so much better. I had so much more energy, and this is probably a story that you've heard before, but it's true, you know? The more when you train, when you exercise, you're making your body stronger. When your body is stronger, you have more energy to do stuff, and when you have more energy to do stuff, you can be more productive. Same thing with food. When you put healthy things into your body, when you have a good diet, when you have a good balanced diet, your body has more energy. You can use more of those energy that your body is producing and then put it into whatever it is that you want to accomplish during the day. You can be more productive because you have more energy. Your body doesn't have to deal with toxins or just spend all the energy trying to get rid of those toxins. You're giving your body this clarity and freedom to do what you want to do. And if you really want to, you know, if you really want to think about how much time that you have to put in to, you know, being healthy. Just think that if you eat right, if you exercise even just 20 minutes, 30 minutes a day, and if you regulate your sleep, it actually gives you so much more time because you won't be tired all the time. You feel stronger to do more things. Like when you are stronger, you can accomplish more things. And I think it seems like you're giving up a lot, but you're not. So let's talk about exercising for a second. When it comes to exercise, I think there's this really stereotypical image of like you have to subscribe to your gym's membership, you have to work out in the gym, you have to sweat, you have to be super self-conscious for like an hour, and then everybody's so skinny and perfect, and you have to go there and then just like feel like shit for an entire hour and exercise. Or you have to go out and jog, or you have to go and enjoy the sunny day and jog in the park or something. So I think there's like a lot of stereotypes that go on with exercising, and I feel like not a lot of people are into that idea of going to the gym to be humiliated or going to the park to jog when you're maybe not really into that kind of thing. I think there's a really narrow idea of exercising, because if you think of exercising, it's physical activity. There's l literally so many things you can do to exercise. And it's the same thing with productivity, you know? You have to experiment and explore a way of being productive that works for you. It's the same thing with exercising. You just have to discover something that you enjoy. Because I believe that we're born to move. We're not born to be sitting on a chair for like 24 hours a day. Our body needs movement, and that movement can happen in any kind of way. It could be in the way that you enjoy, because it seems like if you just think about this for a sec, if you feel like, oh my God, I need to go to the gym and exercise, it already puts a lot of stress on yourself, and you don't want to do that. And that's fine, because I hate going to the gym. Like, I hate going on a treadmill because it's so boring, and I hate jogging because my feet aren't really good with jogging or running, because the arches on my feet aren't even. My left foot is slightly more flat than my right one, so it actually hurts for me to run for a long time. But that could also be that I never really got a proper pair of shoes. But you know, I hate jogging. It's boring. I don't get the runner's high. I don't get it. If you're a runner, then please forgive me. But there's so many exercises out there. You could go play badminton, you could play tennis, you could do pop up, like just, you know, pop on a DVD workout, which is what I do. I watch YouTube videos, and there's so many different fun dynamic workouts up there. Do a dance workout. There's just so many forms of exercising. Do yoga, or just play with your cat, run up and down the stairs listening to Drake or something. You know, be creative, right? Think of creative ways for you to engage in physical activity. It could be something that you like. You just have to find it, you know? It doesn't have to be something so absolutely dreadful, and you have to sweat, and it's gross, and you have to move, and your muscles are sore, and it's disgusting and everything. It doesn't have to be that. It could just be something that you like. And same thing with diet, you know, it seems like you're giving up a lot. You're giving up all that sugar. And when you talk about sugar, it seems like you're giving up the cookies, the cupcakes, the donuts, and everything, all the sugary drinks. It seems like you're giving up a lot. But you're not. If you think about it, there's a lot of healthy food out there, like the greens, all the natural food. I don't want to go into too much details, but just the sheer amount of creativity that people have with these healthy ingredients, trust me, like if you want, you can find something that's freaking delicious, but it's completely healthy. It exists, it's out there, you just have to find it. And honestly, there's n absolutely nothing good about sugar other than the fact that it gets you addicted and makes you think that it's good. That's why it's an addiction. And when it comes to sugar, here's a really quick tip. Start eating just a little bit less each time you order something sugary. For example, when you eat a donut, you can't really control the amount of sugar you put on there, so that would be like a bad example. But maybe just eat like a bite less. And then the next time you have a donut, eat 2 bites less. And then just gradually dial it down. It's like when you get sugar, or when you get like sugary coffee from Starbucks, you know, pumpkin spice latte or something. I love that shit. Sometimes I go and drink it. Instead of 4 pumps of sugar, get 3 pumps, and then do that for like a week or two, and then get 2 pumps. So just slowly dial down your sugar level, and you'll start to taste the difference. You'll start to taste more because now you're getting rid of all these really strong tastes that just override all the subtleties that your tongue is able to detect. So if you do it like just gradually less and less and less, you actually be able to notice the difference. And then when you taste that four, when you're used to like just having one pump of sugar in your coffee, and then you taste the original four pumps, you're gonna be like, wow, I was like used to this kind of shit. Like, how is that even possible? Because your body gets used to eating so much sugar, and then you get numb. You get even more and more numb as you eat more sugar. But when you start to eat less, you get your taste buds back. You get your taste buds back, and slowly but surely, if you kind of just cut away a little bit, you actually won't crave for sugar anymore. You actually won't crave for all those unhealthy things, and you can invest your time and energy into something that takes not a lot of time and that tastes just as good, and that's completely healthy for you. For example, I found guacamole. I mean, the chips are a little bit unhealthy, but you can always make home-baked chips, and guacamole is just amazing. It's avocado with tomatoes and onions and cilantro. It's perfectly healthy snack. You just have to like find whatever that's, that makes you feel good, that makes you feel healthy when you eat it, because those things exist. There's so many delicious food out there that you can find that will make you happy and that will bring you joy, and they don't have to be sugary at all. Yeah, so that's food. And when it comes to sleep, trust me, if you spend 3 days just sleeping 8 hours from, say, like 12 to 8 or 11 to 7, or just 8 hours of, or 7 to 8 hours of good sleep, regulated sleep hours, if you do it for 3 days, you will not want to go back again, even though sometimes snoozing is a little bit hard. But you would notice the difference, and that can be addicting. That can be addicting because you feel more awake, you feel more energy, you feel more like a participant in your life, in this physical plane, and not just a zombie getting by the day, just hoping the day would be over. And that's no way to live, right? You don't want to live like a zombie. And yeah, and when you're not a zombie, you're able to accomplish so much more, because if you imagine a walker from Walking Dead, they're lumbering around, they're like grunting, like, oh, where's my coffee? They're not very active. They don't have a lot of flexibility or energy to accomplish things, right? They're slow as hell. And if you're that, if you're allowing yourself, if you're allowing your body to be that, it's time for a change. It's time to be healthy so you can be more productive, because those things go hand in hand. It's a math equation. Like, most of the time in life, there is no math equation, but this is health, productivity. There's a direct correlation of how much you can do versus how much energy that you have. And it's just supreme law of productivity. You gotta be healthy. You gotta exercise, eat right, and sleep right. There's no way around it. If you're thinking about being productive and you're hesitating about the idea of like investing more time into exercising and eating right and sleeping right, you're never gonna be as productive as you wanna be. Trust me. You gotta be healthy for you to be productive. And period. Like, yeah, the end. End of story. You just gotta do that first so you can do all the other things that will make you more productive. Because those things are like vitamins. If you don't exercise, if you don't have this main, health going on, all the other vitamins aren't gonna help you either. And that's just how it is. What else do I wanna say? I think that's it for now. Being healthy can be a fun thing because it'll make you feel good, it'll allow you to be more productive, and it's like an adventure, It feels like you're giving up a lot of things, but once you know that you're giving up those things for good, and now you have this whole untapped, unexplored area of goodness that you're allowed to go into. Just imagine like the new things that you're gonna try, the new feelings that you're going to experience. Like, exercising could be fun. You just have to find something that makes you feel good and makes you feel like you're enjoying it. There's just so many different things you can do. And when it comes to food, it's the same. Like, if you think about all the culinary arts out there, all the cuisines, and all the possible recipes that are available on the internet, there's gotta be something that will appeal to your taste buds. And when it comes to sleep, well, I feel like this is something that you just have to experience for yourself. If you're kind of having like a wacky sleeping pattern right now, trust me, once you go regular, you wouldn't want to go irregular. It's a really, really bad motto or a really bad sentence. But you know what I mean? It could be a good thing. It is a good thing. It's supposed to be a good thing. It is a good thing. And don't allow that sense of dread or anything, any of that negative baggage surrounding exercise, like, that's surrounding the word health, drag you down. Because you deserve better. You need to take care of yourself because you deserve the best. You need to be the best that you can be. You want to manifest and express your spirit in the best way that you can. And to do that, you need to have a healthy body because you deserve that. You only live once, yo. You only live once. This is the only lifetime that you're going to get to be you. It doesn't matter if you believe in the afterlife or reincarnation or heaven and hell. You will only be who you are, your exact person. You're only going to do it once. You only get to do it once. And if you're not gonna live now, when are you gonna do it? So live now, because you deserve to live now. Like, your spirit wants to express itself, and it can express itself the most when your body is at its optimal. And that's what you deserve. And it's because you deserve to be at your best, like, at all times. And it doesn't have to be like this, and it doesn't have to be a dreadful routine. It's like the energy that you invest in becoming healthy shouldn't be a chore. It should be something that makes you feel alive because it does make you feel alive. So, yeah, I just want you to feel so positive about this because it is such a positive thing. And then this is something I personally went through. And after I really, really invested in making myself healthy and it just I'm not going back to where I was now. Like, I think you would really see the benefits and see all the goodness when you try to be more healthy, when you're cultivating those habits. And just it frees you, it believe it or not, it frees up so much time when you're healthy because you're not tired like all the time anymore. It frees you up so much. It's very liberating. It gives you a lot of potential. And because and it allows you to connect with your with life, with everything around you, Okay, so I think that's all I want to say for now. There's so many dimensions and perspectives to this. There's so many more things I want to say about productivity and health and other stuff about productivity, Yeah, I just want to leave you with that for now. I hope you feel somewhat inspired, at least a little bit, by this, and I hope that you would start your search or start your quest in becoming healthy if you're not already sort of on that path, I guess. I feel like we're just you just gotta find your path. You just gotta find your way of being healthy that allows you to be healthy. So don't feel like you have to just do whatever this perfect yoga instructor person do, and then it's a lot of pressure to live up to an image, but you just have to do it your own way. You just have to find that one thing or just that one way of being healthy that makes you happy, that makes you healthy, and that's the most important thing ever. Because it's supposed to be fun, it's supposed to be a good thing. I can't stress this enough. So yeah, that's all I want to say for today. And until next time, be the hero of your own story, guys, and be healthy. Be a healthy hero. Yeah, because you can't fight wars and go on adventures if you're a sick hero. And you can't live out your story if you're sick and if you're tired and if your back is aching all the time. Da 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 da. So yeah, be the hero of your own story and see you next time. Whew.